that music instruction,
Welcome to Accent Music Instruction. In this video, we're going to learn about compound time signatures. This is the second in a series of videos on time signatures. The first one was on simple time signatures. I'll be referencing that video, so if you haven't watched it, please watch it now. When we learned about simple meters, we learned that each main beat is split into two smaller parts, and in compound meter, each main beat is split into three smaller parts. All right, the first time signature we're gonna check out is 6/8. So if you watched our last video, you're probably thinking, okay, 6/8. We have six beats in a measure, and the eighth note gets the beat. Here's where things get a little confusing with compound time signatures. You're not wrong. You could definitely count 6/8 as 6/8 notes in a measure, and thinking of the eighth notes as the beat. However, most of the time, 6/8 is fast. And it's so fast that you probably wouldn't feel the main beat as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 or something like that, right? You wouldn't feel every single one of those beats as like the main beat. It's too fast. What we do is we think of the dotted quarter note as the beat. And there's going to be two dotted quarter notes in 6/8. So it's actually kind of like we have two beats in a measure. We have two main beats, and then we have six smaller beats. So each of those main beats is being split into three smaller parts.
For 6/8, we can count 1, 2, just count the big beats, or we can count the smaller beats as well and count 1 and 2 and. All right, there's lots of ways to count 6/8, and people have different preferences. I actually have some problems with counting 6/8 as 1 and 2 and, but that's something for another video.
All right, let's check out Lights by Journey. I want you to look at the drum part.
When the lights go down in the city and the sun shines on the bay.
All right, we can see that the bass drum is emphasizing the main beat 1, and the snare drum is emphasizing main beat 2. The hi-hat is splitting each of those main beats into three parts. So very clearly, 6/8 and compound time. You can hear that the guitar plays along with the same rhythm of the hi-hat. It actually accents the main beats as well. Let's listen to that one more time.
When the lights go down in the city,
now we're going to learn about 12/8. Just like 6/8, you could count to 12, and that's done when it's at a slow tempo. But more often than not, it's at a faster tempo than that. And we're only going to count to 4. So each main beat, again, is split into three smaller parts. So let's listen to Hold the Line by Toto, which is in 12/8.
Hold the line.
Similarly to the drum part in Lights that we listened to, the bass drum is emphasizing beats 1 and 3 this time, because now we have 4 main beats, and the snare drum is emphasizing beats 2 and 4. The hi-hat, just like in Lights, just plays those eighth notes, which shows us that each beat is split into three smaller parts. And you can also see that the piano is playing eighth notes. Let's listen again.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and.
Next time signature is 9/8. We can count up to 9 if it's slow, right? That does happen. Often, there's just 3 main beats in 9/8, and each of them are split into 3 smaller parts. Let's listen to Joy by Johann Sebastian Bach. In this piano version, this was originally not for piano, In this piano version, you can see that the left hand is emphasizing the main beats, and the right hand is playing the eighth notes, showing us that each of these main beats is split into three smaller parts. Let's listen to that one more time.
One, two, three, one, and a two, and a three, and a...
All right, last but certainly not least is 3-4. 3-4 can fairly easily be either simple or compound. So a lot of it has to do with which note really is the main beat, right? So in a lot of songs, like Piano Man, I think of as compound. Let's listen to the Piano Man, and you'll see what I mean, how it's really only one beat in a measure. It's one main beat, and then they're split into three smaller beats. So even though it's 3-4, it's one main beat.
One and a, one and a, one and a.
If we listen to Burning Bridges by Pink Floyd, we can hear that it's in simple time. We hear three distinct main beats, and we can tell that they're each split into two smaller parts. So let's listen to that. So 3-4 can be either compound or simple. Next video, we're going to get even crazier with time signatures. We're going to check out asymmetric time signatures, sometimes called odd time signatures. So that's things like 7-8, 5-8, 13-8, 11-8, even 1916. The time signature, not the year. All right, if you like this video, please like, subscribe, ring that notification bell if you're crazy. Thanks for watching.
Like and subscribe if you like this video, and like and subscribe.